I'm Julie Marcus, the senior horticulturist at the Lady Bird Johnson Wildflower Center, and I'd like to show you some of the early spring bloomers that are attractive to hummingbirds during the spring migration. We have here our red buckeye. It is Aeschylus pava, and it has the little tubular flowers that make the hummingbird with their long bill able to access the nectar. This red buckeye is found, it's blooming now here in central Texas, and it's found here, but it's also found down along the coast in select areas and further down into South Texas. Let's go over here and look at another hummingbird favorite. This is our Cedar Sage, Salvia romariana, and it's just starting to bloom. But again, note the tubular shaped flowers on that. Perfect for the hummingbird to nectar from. The Cedar Sage, as you notice, is growing in kind of a shaded area, like the red buckeye. They prefer shade. They can take morning sun, but they do like a little respite, like all of us, from that afternoon sun. When the hummingbirds are migrating, a kind of interesting fact is that the males come through first to set up territory, and then the females will come through. Here at the Wildflower Center, I've started just recently to see the females come through. I've been hearing the males and seeing them nectar on some of these plants, but I did see some females earlier in the week. This is one of my favorite vines, and again, beautiful tubular shaped flower, just perfect for our hummingbird to nectar from. This is called our crossvine, Bignonia capriolata, and this one is found a little primarily east of us, toward East Texas, but it's just fabulous. It grows along the in the woods, and it will bloom about to mid-spring, and then it'll have these really long seed pods that are quite attractive. But I just saw a little bee go into one of the other little flowers over there, so it is a great bee attractant also. One of the last plants we're going to talk about today is another favorite. I have so many favorites. It's really hard. It's like trying to pick a favorite child. But this is our coral honeysuckle, sometimes referred to as flame honeysuckle. Blooms starting in early spring and just is vibrant all summer long. It will take sun, but it also will take a little bit of light shade. It's kind of an edge plant. Bright shade. This one, again, has the beautiful tubular-shaped flowers. And if you notice that they kind of nod and hang down. And that's not any problem for a hummingbird. They don't have to have a flower that stands out straight. They, if you've ever observed them, they are quite fascinating to watch. They can hover, they can fly up, they fly down, they fly backwards. They're the little acrobat. But again, the beautiful tubular shaped flowers are just a favorite nectar. I'm seeing a few bees flying in and out here. They love that too. So it's a nice nectar source for them too. So I showed you today just a few of the beautiful native plants that you might want to add to your garden to attract and support hummingbirds during their spring migration. And who doesn't want to do that?